In this video, we show you how to operate the web server for KOSTAL inverters in the PLENTICORE and PIKO IQ series. You can call up the web server using the browser on your PC, laptop, smartphone, or tablet. The device must be in the same network as the inverter. Enter the inverter's IP address into the address bar and confirm by pressing Enter. The login page is loaded. Select the installer user group and enter the master key for your device and your personal service code. Logging in as an installer gives you advanced setting options, which are not available to the plant owner and require specialist knowledge. Confirm the danger notice and disclaimer of liability and click on the login. You are now on the home screen with the power flow diagram. This shows how the power is split between the grid, inverter, and house in real time. The current values and statistics menus show the performance and yield data for the device. Go to the Settings menu. Under the Basic Settings menu, you can change the inverter name, configure the date and time, and change the login password for the web server. The date and time are determined automatically via the preset NTP server. Please select the time zone for your location. If the inverter is not connected to the internet, remove the tick from Use Time Server NTP. Set the date and time manually, or transfer from the device used to access the web server. Then click on Save to accept the settings. The Network menu item allows you to set the network parameters for the inverter. The Automatically Acquire IPv4 address option is activated by default. This means that the inverter receives its IP address from the DHCP server, located in the local network. If you want a manual IP configuration, remove the tick and enter the values you want in the fields. Confirm the changes by clicking on the Save button. If you want to read the information about the Modbus protocol from the device or control this, activate modbus/sunspec-tcp. This enables data to be exchanged with a compatible external device, which is linked with the inverter via your network. Activate the KOSTAL Solar Portal. Then, when you have an internet connection, operating values and events are sent to the KOSTAL Solar Portal. And you can conveniently display and evaluate the system data online. More options for configuring the inverter can be found in the service menu. This is split into general settings and settings for grid parameterization. If you are using an energy meter, you can select the meter fitted from the overview in the Energy Management menu item and select the feeding capacity to the public grid. The power is already preset to maximum AC power. If you have any shading on your roof, for example, the Generator Settings menu item allows you to activate shadow management for each DC string individually. The inverter software then automatically optimizes the yields of the modules in shade. Once you have connected a battery to the inverter, you can go to the Battery Settings menu item, select the battery type, and configure the battery's use strategy. When in automatic operating mode, the inverter controls battery use in the same way all year round depending on PV yields. When in automatically economical mode, the battery is shut down when the PV yield is very low for several days. The PLENTICORE Plus has a generation and consumption forecast, which works with the connected battery to make the electricity generated available to the consumers in the household in an optimum manner. Activate the smart battery control if you want to use this forecast and reduce your electricity costs as much as possible. Go to the external hardware settings menu item. The inverter can be used with a type A residual current sensor. In some cases, you may have to deactivate this function and fit a type B sensor. The digital inputs menu item allows you to configure the operating mode of the digital inputs on the smart communication board. Evaluation of an external trip signal or changing over the set of parameters is, for example, stipulated in some countries. Select the function you need and connect the inputs in accordance with the connection diagram shown. If restriction on the feed-in capacity using ripple control signal is stipulated for the PV system, the receiver needed for this can be connected to the digital inputs as shown in this connection diagram. If you are using several KOSTAL inverters, activate the distribution of the broadcast control signals. The corresponding command, e.g., shut down all devices, is then sent to all devices present in the system by means of a broadcast via the network. The settings for the user-defined active/reactive power control operating mode can be configured individually. You will usually receive the relevant requirements from your energy provider. In the switched output menu, you can set the self-consumption terminal function on the smart communication board. You can choose between two functions and individually set the activation and deactivation conditions. The self-consumption control function relates to the output power of the inverter. Dynamic self-consumption control is only possible in conjunction with an energy meter and relates to the power at the grid connection point. If you want to release an additional function, e.g. battery mode for the Plenticore Plus, you will need an activation code that you can obtain from the KOSTAL online shop. The additional options released are shown here. On request, the AC output parameters can be modified using the menu items in the grid parameterization area. Your grid operator will provide you with the relevant requirements. However, adjustments are not normally needed. The parameters in the selected guideline already match the country-specific requirements. The parameterization report provides an overview of the parameters set in the inverter. You can view and, if necessary, print out the report. If you want to check that the grid and system protection is working properly, launch the self-test. Afterwards, the results are displayed and can be printed out. In the Update menu, you can define when you want the software to be updated fully automatically when you have an internet connection. If you do, there is no need to do anything. Select the Inform when update is available option if you simply want to be notified of an available update. As soon as a new version is available, the icon in the header line will change. Clicking on the icon takes you to the Update menu, where you can start the software update process. If you prefer, you can start the search for online updates yourself. For a manual software update, drag the update file into the field or select it using the button and start the installation process. The info menu provides information about the device data, such as the hardware and software version or the set network parameters. Once you have logged in, the event messages registered by the device are also listed for you. Use the logout symbol to log out again.